We already have the Boolean expression. How can we generate or make a truth table? This is another step. Okay, as I mentioned, the Boolean expression, circuit diagram, and the truth table, they are the same thing. We can convert among them. Okay, so we already convert from circuit diagram to Boolean expression. Now we want to convert from Boolean expression, which is this one. How can we construct a truth table? Okay. So how do we do? Think about it. Good. So now let's think about how to generate the truth table. See, we have four variables. Okay. As we mentioned, four variables, we could have 16 possibilities. We just list all the possibilities for input variables. This is how we make a truth table from input point of view. See, four variables. We just list all possibilities there. An output. We just put the correct numbers, 0 or 1s, to the correct locations. Okay, 0, 1, 0, 1s, with respect to input combinations. Then we can finish truth table. Okay, this is how we do it. Okay, let's think about how can we finish this job. How can we put the zeros ones at the correct locations? Think about this one. Okay, think about how if we know zeros. Okay, if we know zeros at particular locations, and other location will be all ones. So let's think about zeros. How can we make this one to equal to zero? Think about it. It's a times a bracket over all variable. Think about if a equals zero, doesn't matter other variables. Okay, output will be equal to zero. So just pick up anywhere you see a is zero. And just write down zero to the output. Okay. So we have zeros up to here. We just put zeros up to there. We finish half of the truth table. Okay, that's quick. Okay, should be eight. Okay. Yeah, when a equals zero, so we just put the output to be zero. All right, so what if a is not zero? A is one, which means these conditions, right? If a is ones, what do we do? Then we need to think about this part. If this part is zero, output will be zero, right? So how can we miss this one part? This part to be zero. If B is zero, if B is zero, C, D must be zero. Zero plus zero, we make sure this overall part is zero. So which means will be this part to be zero. Okay. Have we finished? How about B is 1? B is 1 and cannot be 0, right? So this is one condition. How about another condition? It will be 0, 1, CD. Okay. Another condition will be 1, 0. Which means this one and this one. If B is one, we will make everything else to be one. Okay. Now we finish this truth table. All right, make sense? Now let's play some interesting theme. Okay. Just now we think about the zero as special case. How about if we pick up ones? Okay. If we put ones first and other conditions will be zeros. Okay, make sense? So to make this one to be one, A must be one. And this part must be one. One times one will be one. Okay. And how to make this part to be one? If B is one, C and D doesn't matter, right? So we can say C and D doesn't matter. Could be zero, could be one, one, zero. Which means will be these four cases. One, 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 one. Okay, if B is one, zero, and CD must be one, one, to make sure it's overall to be one, which is this case. Okay. Then we look at from one perspective and others must be all zero. Okay, can you follow? Just some logics there. So the key thing here I want to mention is we could look at from zero conditions to pick up all the possibilities, put the zeros and the rest will be one. Also, we can do another way. Look at the special case of one, put the ones there, others will be zero. So they are all the same thing. Okay, it's a truth table. Okay, that's it. It's how we derive from Boolean expression to truth table. We can either look at zero as special condition, or we can look at one as special condition, and so put the opposite numbers in for the output. Actually, in the lab one, the final task will be some homework. You can do your design task for a particular question will be similar thing. All right, and let's move on.